Hello everyone. Greetings to you all in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I believe you're doing good, and I believe that you are experiencing the hand of God in your life. And those who are watching me for the first time, this is Evans Francis from Nagpur, India. I'm an evangelist into full-time ministry from last 13 years. And if you are watching me for the first time, consider subscribing, hit the bell icon, so whenever I come live, I share a video or a post, you will be notified. And today I will be sharing a dream, a vision, and a prophecy that God gave me for the body of Christ. And I'm very particular when I get a message from the Lord. Earlier, even if I get a dream, I was coming live and sharing, but now I'm just taking a while, and I will be complying like 2-3 visions or dreams together, so it will not take many times I don't have to come live, but in one video you will get all the message. And I believe that that God has a plan and God has a purpose, and those who are watching me, I believe that God has a special purpose for you. That's why he has connected you with us, and I believe that the plan of God will prevail in your life. So without wasting a lot of time, let us pray. Father God, we come to thy presence in this wonderful time. Master Lord, we come to the throne of grace. I give your children into thy hand, their lives into thy hands. No work of the devil, no work of the evil one prevail upon their life, Master. Speak to them, Master, through your word. And Lord, let your name alone be glorified. I cancel all the disturbances in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. So again, I just want to say that whatever I will be sharing, I'll listen with a learning heart. And if you are going to listen this with a critical mind, with a mindset of a critic, it will be a waste for you. But I know there are people who listen to my message with an open heart, and I know that God speaks to you through these messages. And on June 9th, Sunday, when I was in the church worshiping God, God showed me an open eye vision. And in the vision, I saw that something falling from the sky, and it was not one or two, but I saw small fireballs sort of falling from the sky, and it was burning. And it was not happening like one coming then another, it was like falling consecutively. And I asked the Holy Spirit that what is happening. First I thought, is it the rapture? But rapture will be people going up, it is not coming down. So the Holy Spirit reminded me from Matthew chapter 24 verses 29-31. I will read, and you can read that whole chapter after this video. And I will do a detailed message, a video on this. And but I believe that today I will just stick to the point what I want to share. So Matthew 24 verses 29-31, it says, but you read when you read the complete chapter, you will understand it better. But it says from 29-31, immediately after the anguish of those days, the sun will be darkened, the moon will give no light, the stars will fall from the sky, and the powers in the heaven will be shaken. And then at last the sign that the Son of Man is coming will appear in the heavens, and there will be deep mourning among the people of the earth, and they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he will send out his angels with the mighty blast of trumpet, and they will gather his chosen one from all over the world, from the farthest ends of the earth and heaven. And when I read the 29th word, it says the stars will fall from the sky. So I understood that what God showed me was something that the stars are falling. That means, beloved, that we are in the last of last days. So it is very important that you don't play with your life, become serious about your life, your eternity with Christ. And I believe that if God shows anything to me or any servant of God, I believe that there is a purpose, because I believe that through this video, if you're watching this video, you will prepare yourself the time is coming very near. And but I got a bad news for you and those who are waiting for rapture to happen, and those who think there will be a rapture. And the bad news is there is no rapture. Rapture is another subject. I will do a video on that. But there is no rapture in the Word of God. It is being made by man. And when you read the book of Revelation in one stretch, you will understand that. And even when you read Matthew 24, where Jesus telling what will be the sign of his coming, there also Jesus didn't say that I will come without telling anybody and I will come and take you. No, the believers, the body of Christ, will go through the tribulation. But remember, if God, when the people in Egypt, they were going through the pestilence, you know, God took care of the people of his people in Goshen. You know, we serve the same God. Even in the time of tribulation, when people will be going through it, you know, God will take care and preserve his children. And when Jesus went to the heaven, ascended to heaven, he didn't do it silently. He did it in a public way. You know, he went into the sky and said, I'm coming back. So remember that it is another topic that I will surely will do a video on that. But remember that you have to, there are a lot of Christians, they think before the tribulation comes, we will not be here. But remember, you need to be prepared. You will go through the tribulation and you need to read the Word of God in one stretch. That's what happens. The problem comes that when we read a book in chapters, which was not the will of God, you know, many times such things happen and we don't take time to study the Word of God just because we have been taught and we just follow it. And because of that mentality, you know, we read the Word of God and we take the text out of context from here and there and we try to make it that, okay, this is rapture. But when I do a detailed video on that, that time you will understand that better. And that was it, the first thing. I saw the stars falling, God showed me. So remember that we are in the last of last days. Now it doesn't matter for God, you will say it's been 2000 years. If he has not come till now, when will he come? But remember, the Word of God says for one day for him is 1000 years. And 1000 years is like one day. So it might be for just 2 days for God. And only the Father knows when Jesus has to come. Not even Jesus knows that. So don't be fooled when people say that he's coming, he's there on this day and that day. That's rubbish. Are you getting me? And after that, I think some few days back, I saw a dream. And it was a short dream. And in the dream, God showed me a dog. And when I saw the dog, he was eating a newborn baby. I don't know, boy or girl. And I was like, so much I had that heart feeling that what is this, why this dog is eating this newborn baby. And I remembered Matthew 24, same chapter 12 to 13, it says, because of the increase of wickedness or lawlessness or sin, the love of most will grow cold, but the one who stands firm to the end will be saved. In short, beloved, that people will live in a way of life that refuses to recognize God's law, divine law, and believe also. They will not believe even that God exists. That day is coming in the coming past. Even these things are happening, already happened. But still, the dream itself, the God is warning us that a time of lawlessness, the wickedness is going to increase. People will have no humanity for each other. They will have no love. They will become selfless. They will become lovers of themselves. This is something that we are going through. And many of you watching me, you will also say yes, because you have also seen people that they have no whatsoever respect for human, even for God. They live in a way that God doesn't exist. They live in a way that there is no parents in their life. So beloved, this time is coming. and the time of lawlessness is increasing. You need to be very prayerful. Only through prayer you will be able to surpass to through this situation in your life when it comes. And day before yesterday, when I was sleeping, the Lord spoke to me. And on Sundays I become very tired because I have to go to the church and manage everything. So 2:30 we leave the house, we reach home by 9, sometime 9:30, sometime even 10:30. So that day I reached 10:30 at home, and while I was lying on my bed and I was meditating on the Lord spoke to me, and he started to speak to me, and I didn't have paper or pen, so whatever he was telling me, I started to write on the phone. And it was like that in the middle, like, you know, 2-3 times it happened that I was dodged, I slept, and immediately I will feel that God woke me up. And then again he started to say to me things, and I started to write again. And but out of that, what God asked me to write, I have written it, and I believe that it will be a blessing to you. And the Lord said to me, "My son, my people have become just like the other 9 lepers, ungrateful. They have no gratitude towards me whatsoever. I gave up my life for them, but that is not enough for them. They come to me for their selfish needs. Hardly anyone I find with a heart filled with thanks. They claim to follow me from their mouth, but their heart is far, far away from me. They like pagans going to different churches and prayer towers, hoping to get a miracle, but they forget their miracle is in their hand. Until and unless they bring a change within their lives, nothing is gonna happen. Many false prophets devil has appointed to deceive the elect. They are following the gift, not the fruits, and devil has blinded them so that they may not see the truth. The spirit of lawlessness is increasing day by day. Soon churches will get empty, and as the seeds which fell on rocky places where it did not have much soil, it sprang up quickly because the soil was shallow. But when the sun came, the plants were scorched and they withered because they had no root. They hear the word of God, the people, at once they receive with joy. But since they have no root, they last only for a short time. When troubles or persecution comes because of the word, they quickly fall away. But if they repent and turn back to me, I still can change their situation, a very hard situation they are going through. But remember, there will be a heavy testing of faith, and during this test, I will separate the sheep from the goats." People of God, put your trust in me and do not lean unto your own understanding. Time is very near for my return, says the Lord. Repent. My people, you are asking a word from God, but within, totally you are corrupt by the world. Many are finding prophecy as amusing. But remember, my people, I come quickly. Keep watch and pray that you will not give in to temptation, for the spirit is willing, but the body is weak, says the Lord. Beloved, if you listen to it, it is something very clear, crystal clear. The message is for the last days. You know, there is not any mention of end times. We always use the word end time, but in the Bible there is no mention of end time. The Bible mentions the last days. It is very important that we will be tried, tested, and those who wait upon the Lord they will be triumphant. And that's what we need to become. That's what God wants us to become. But what is happening is that we are becoming like the nine lepers. If you see that parable or that story mentioned in the Word of God, those nine were who? People of Israel. The one who came was a Samaritan, and he came back to thank God. And that's what God was telling me, that my people, my children, have become full of ungratitude. Remember, if you have gratitude towards God, that what he has done, there will be no attitude in your life. You will know that whatever you have, whatever you're going to have, and whatever you have, your children will have, or anybody will have, it's because of grace and mercy of God. And that is what is missing in the body of Christ today, a lifestyle of having gratitude for the Lord. In the end, I will just read a verse from 2 Peter chapter 3, verses 3 and 4 and 8 and 9. It says, "Above all, you must understand that in the last days, scoffers will come, scoffing and following their own evil desire. They will say, 'Where is this coming he promised? For even our ancestors died. Everything goes on as it has since the beginning of creation.'" Verse 8 and 9. "But do not forget this one thing, dear friends. With the Lord, a day is like a thousand years, and a thousand years are like a day. The Lord is not slow in keeping his promise, as some understand slowness. Instead, he is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance." Beloved, there will be many scoffers, many mockers. They will say that if he had to return, he would have returned by now. Now he is not going to return. And Jesus said that it will be the time of the Noah, that everybody will be enjoying, partying. They will be so much into the world that they forget that Christ is going to return. And that will be the moment when Jesus comes. Remember, when I give this message, I know many of you will be repenting, will be coming back to the Lord. But when you see things are not happening again, you'll go back. But remember, Jesus will come when you least expect it. That is the time. And that's what, when Jesus says, when the Word of God says he comes as a thief, he's not coming as a thief for the unbelievers. He's coming as a thief to the believers who are sleeping, who are not ready, who are not watching and praying. But we who know the Word of God, for me, you know, I know that when Christ will come, what is going to happen before that. So I am not going, if somebody quoting a date, somebody quoting the year or a month, I know my Word of God and what the Word of God says. So when the Bible says that he's coming as a thief, he's coming as a thief to you. When you are not prepared and you are living in this world as if you are an unbeliever, you don't know the truth, you are in sin. And when Jesus will come, you will be caught with surprise. Unbelievers, they are blind, they don't know the truth. But you will be caught with surprise. And for you, he will come as a thief. I hope you're getting my point, that what I'm saying. Let us pray. Father God, we come to thy presence in this wonderful time, Master. Lord, we come to your throne of grace. I give your children into thy hand, their lives into thy hands, Master. Lord, help them to prepare their altars, Master. Repair their life, Master, and be prepared all the time so that they will not miss you and they will not find it surprise your coming. But they will be prepared, Master, that when you come, they will be watching like that five virgins who have, Lord, saved the oil with them, Master. Lord, you're doing it for that. I thank you. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. 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 I believe this video has blessed you. If this video has blessed you, see to it that you share it with your friends and loved ones. And if you're watching it for the first time, consider subscribing. Hit the bell icon. and share with your friends. God bless you. Shalom.